Come in.
Ho, ho, ho. I bring you the greetings of Yuletide.
Ho, ho, ho. Go down to the ocean side and stand in the low tide until the high tide commits suicide.
You don't upset me, Fred Sanford. I have the feeling of Christmas.
And the face of Halloween.
What are you starting something for, Pop? Hi, Aunt Esther. Listen, I'm in a hurry. Was there anything I can do for you before I leave?
Just put these under your tree, sweetheart.
Oh, thanks a lot. Hey, here's a present here for you, Pop.
You spend money on me?
It's not the amount of money one spends on a gift, Fred. It's the thought behind it.
What is it?
Who cares? Look, if you leave and I'm going with you, honey, because your father's getting on my nerves.
I wouldn't get on no part of it.
You think you smart, Fred Sanford. But as my Spanish-speaking friends would say, adios, sucker.
Hey! Hey!
What are you doing with that apple?
I was thinking of going fishing tomorrow, and I'm looking for a worm.
I mean, do you have to eat while you're working?
Don't worry, I can do two things at the same time.
I don't want you to do two things at the same time.
Okay, you're the boss.
Put the apple away.
That's what I'm doing.
George, what are you doing home so early?
I got a business appointment coming up here, an advertising guy.
Ooh, I wouldn't trust one of them.
Who asked you?
I wouldn't believe nothing them advertising folks say, especially in them commercials.
Look, you just get back to work. Advertising is good for business.
All I know is none of them detergents ever turned my hands soft and white.
Will you shut that damn thing off?
You told me to get back to work.
Do it someplace else.
I already did the someplace else.
You better get out.
Florence, why don't you put on some coffee?
Anything you say, Miss Jefferson.
My show will be slamming.
I'm with it.
You happy?
Now, how are we getting up out of here with all the people outside?
Bam, bam, there it is. We just saddle up Pam and just gallop right through the crowd. Just... right through there.
Whatever, Arsenio Small. Get out of my way.
Get out of my way.
What's up, Biggie? You know, I just came over to say hello to my girlfriend, Gina. How about I call her? Gina! What's up? Oh, Gina. Yeah.
That's probably her now. Now, Pop, try to be nice to her.
All right, get the dough.
Hello, Aunt Esther.
Hello, Lamont.
Hey, Uncle Woody.
Oh, that's all right, Lamont. I'll pull my arm.
Hello, Fred.
Hello, Woody.
Hello, Fred Sanford, and how are you today?
Fine up to now.
Will you stop that?
Okay. I'm quite fine, Esther. And may I lie and say how nice it is to see you?
How's your neck on, Esther?
It's much better, thank you. May I sit down?
Certainly, I'll push the couch out on the freeway.
Mr. Jefferson, you had no call to talk to my friend like that.
And you have no call to shout at my husband like that.
That's right, because I ain't the one that did something wrong.
Are you saying I did?
Well, if the shoe fits, step in it.
get one thing straight, honey. Just because TJ spent the night here don't mean something happened.
He was in your bedroom.
Well, so was a TV set and a dressing table, but they wasn't in bed with me neither.
That part's none of our business anyway, George.
Oh, yes, it is. I don't want any of that part in this apartment.
It's none of our business.
If I was you, I'd listen to my wife. When it comes to brains in this family, you outvoted. 1-0.
And when it comes to nerves, you could carry the whole country. Ha, ha, ha.
George, we are not here to judge Florence's morals.
What morals? Look, I'm here to get me some breakfast, which her boyfriend already stole.
He didn't steal it. I gave it to him.
Oh, yeah? Well, it's coming out of your salary.
Well, let's see. That's one cup of coffee and one piece of toast. 2 weeks' pay ought to cover it.
I guess I'll be going. Thanks for the loan of your robe.
You lucky I didn't loan you my foot.
Which one? The one you standing on or the one in your mouth?
girl.
Yeah. See, now you fighting dirty. You didn't have to bring a van to Uglyfield into this.
Is Sitting Bull.
Oh, Fred.
Where you get all busting in my door anyway?
I'm sorry, Fred. It's an emergency. I need help.
Help? I'm just a junk man, not a plastic surgeon.
Please, Fred, I need your truck.
I agree, son. You take the truck and run over Esther's face.
What's going on?
Felicia thinks Mr. Bentley wants to marry her.
Where did she ever get a dumb idea like that? Oh, direct from the factory.
Look, Florence, we don't need your 2 cents.
You need all the sense you can get.
Who this?
It's me, Pam.
What's the password?
Open the door, dummy.
That ain't no damn password. All right, come on.
Stupid.
Come on. Come on. Oh, girl, good disguise. I didn't recognize you. You look like a human being. Go on.
Yeah, you look like a normal size adult. Whose shoulders you standing on?
All right, now look, check it out. Gotta get down to business. This is what I want. Now, we gotta dig up as much dirt on Monique as we can get, okay? All of it.
Definitely. We gotta show Gino just what time it is with her girl.
Hey, enough said. Okay, did you bring the night vision goggles? Did you bring them?
Night vision goggles, man.
You look like you got military style ones, too.
Gotta hold.
Let me see. Hey, whoa! Yeah, they got you right up in the thing. Right up in the something.
Okay.
Did you bring the secret surveillance camera? Did you bring that?
Got that.
Okay.
Zoom lens.
Okay. All right, you want to pose?
Yeah, wait, let me get you. Nah.
Okay, that's for all the brothers on lockdown. That's for all the brothers. Okay, now, did you bring the new Biggie Smalls album?
Yeah, I got that.
You got the Biggie?
Right here, Bow.
All right. Baby! Yeah, that's what I'm talking about.
What you need that for?
I lost mine. This is coming handy. I got to get down on Biggie, okay? Well, look. Hey, we got to do this like teamwork, okay? We're partners, okay? It's like Jordan and Pippen.
Yeah.
In our case, Elroy and Astra.
Shut up, girl. Come on, let's just get out.
Okay,
well,
tip
out. Watch your back.
Okay, watch your back. I got yours, you got mine. Slipping dip.
Hi. Would y'all like to celebrate your big business deal with a bottle of champagne? There's one open in the kitchen.
Florence, I fired you.
I know. That's what I'm celebrating.
But what are you still doing here?
I had to finish my cleaning. Ain't no sense to Miss Jefferson suffering because you're such a meanie. And such a bad speller, too.
Say what?
You spelled your name wrong. That check ain't no good.
What are you talking about? It says George Jefferson playing his day.
That's what I mean. It should say George Pigeon.
Say what?
That's what his partner called you on the telephone just now. And I know, because I was listening.
Surprise party, man. Please, you better go to McDonald's Playland and call it a day. You hear me, John?
Yeah. I wasn't even talking to you, Mariah Scary.
Baby, okay, look, about this party. Now, you should have told me earlier, honey. It's really hard to plan a surprise party on such a short notice.
Short notice? That's the only notice that Martin can give. Short, did you get it? That was funny.
You a wild girl. Well, I tell you what, you could come too, Pam. And why don't you invite Noah and some of your four-legged friends from the ark?
I'll get that.
Hello, Fred.
Hello, Woody. Goodbye, Woody.
What are you doing that for? Hey, come on in, Uncle Woody. You too, honest, man.
Not until that heathen apologizes for slamming the door in my face.
She's right, Pop. Apologize.
I apologize, Esther, for slamming the door in your face.
Well, that's better.
My neighbor's kids over here. This place is better than the zoo.
So we're gonna start right now.
Bam. So, Pam.
Hey, girl, how you doing?
All right. So what are you going to do tomorrow?
Well, tomorrow I was gonna get my hair done. But, you know, I changed my mind because it looks so good. Don't you all agree?
Okay.
Excuse me? Is that something that you had to say, Popcorn Trip? I didn't think so. And you know what? Then I got to go get my workout. You know, keep my figure looking tight.
All right.
Yes, girl. I gotta have my apartment fumigated. Somebody in my building has fleas. I don't know how they got there. I mean, could you tell me?
All right, I'll tell you. It's you, Muttley. You the one with the damn fleas.
I'd say we still have a reason to celebrate. Anybody want a drink?
Yes.
Ooh, wait a minute. I'll go get the napkin.
Hold on, come back here.
But Mr. Jefferson, I'm only doing what a maid is supposed to do.
Wrong. I'll show you what a maid is supposed to do. Florence, I need a drink.
Me too, and make mine a double.
Look, Gina! It's a munchkin trick-or-treater! Trick-or-treat, you're a slob. Did you lose another job?
Why you gotta go there, Sounder? Shouldn't you be down at the airport sniffing luggage?
Hold on, Montel. Don't come up in here bum rushing, my lady. That goes for you and the horse you rode in on.
How do you do? How nice
come
of you
right in.
Mr. and Mrs. Luckman.
Mr. and Mrs. Luckman.
I can hear them, Florence. How do you do? How are you?
Come right in.
Wait, please. Mr. George Jefferson.
I know who I am.
Lord have mercy. Is there no hope at all?
Not for your face.
He's both. He's little and he's bad. Gina, think about it.
Is that your breath? Smelling like boiled bologna? Well, Pam, I got a problem with your breath smelling like train smoke. Girl, your hair's so nappy, Wilson couldn't pick it. Just me, you, Tommy, and Mama Duke.
And he's so nice.
nice to that Pam. Martin told me on the way over that she was raised by wolves.
Well, I hope they do weaves in the joint, because that's where you go. A weave a dirt sheet.
Oh, yes.
Too many questions about what happened today.
Oh, Mr. Jefferson, I ain't gonna ask you no questions.
You ain't?
No, I'm just gonna sit right here and keep my mouth shut.
Good.
While you tell me how Mr. Willis saved your life.
Ain't nothing to tell.
How did it feel to be dead?
How should I know?
I heard you had gone and passed on to your reward until Mr. Willis brought you back.
What?
Did you get to talk to the devil?
Look, Florence.
What did he look like?
He looked like you, only pretty.
Pam, you can leave too. Your master's leaving.
I don't like you, you evil little troll. Get out of my way.
Fred.
Forget Smitty, son. Call SWAT.
Shut up, heathen. Well, Fred, I see you finally got rid of all that old useless furniture in this house. But what are you still doing here?
Quick, son, get the raid so we can kill this fungus before it multiplies.
Will you stop that? Somebody robbed us on Esther. They really cleaned us out.
Well, I guess that's what they mean by good riddance to bad rubbish.
And I guess you what they mean when they say into each life some ugly must fall.
Watch it, sucker.
I've been looking all over for you.
Damn, Gina. You ain't got to be sweating a brother and all of that. All up in here.
On the real, on the real.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, babe, why you have to play me so tight, baby?
It's real tight. You know what I mean?
We about to go down to Nipsey, play some pool.
Yeah, I'm about to open up a can of whoop ass on you, boy.
Oh, no, it ain't like that. Don't you try. You ain't gonna open up on no...
Bell!
So, you mean to tell me that you two are actually, you want to hang out together?
Who, me and Sydney Shorty? Hang?
Hell no!
Oh, that's... You had just said that we were cool like...
Okay, Martin. Pam, what? Ever since you came from the dentist, it seems like you have a split personality or something.
Baby, she does have a split personality. She's half woman and half horse. Buckham! I said Buckham!
Shut up! No, that's not it. It's something else, baby, and I think I know what it is.
What's up? Yo, y'all ready to roll, sister? I'm ready to roll.
She's still hypnotized. Baby, she is you.
But baby.
Whoa. Can't nobody beat me but me, Jaina. So what you saying? Pam's stealing my steelo?
I'm stealing your steelo?
Oh, you like that?
You living fine.
Miss Jefferson. Miss Jefferson.
Hmm? What?
Miss Jefferson.
Florence?
Can I come in?
George, it's Florence.
Oh, no, not in my dreams, too.
What time is it?
Oh, it ain't late. It's 4:30.
4:30? Is the building burning down?
No.
Did somebody die?
No.
Then you're fired! Oh, stop it, George. Now, what's the matter, Florence?
Oh, Miss Jefferson, I just been tossing and turning. I can't sleep.
Why don't you just close your eyes and try counting unemployment checks?
Anything else we can do to help? Like if he needs an organ, yeah. Like a cow heart or something, we got the whole cow right here. Oh. All right, Pop. You got that?
Got it.
Oh, hi, sir.
What you doing walking around talking to yourself like a fool?
Come here, sir. Huh? Don't move now. Don't move, just be calm. Don't get excited, and don't move to your right. Sort of ease over to your left, son, because I'm positive there's some fungus growing over there.
Watch it, sucker. I don't have to take no insults from you.
You sure don't. Just look in the mirror.
Pop, do you always have to attack Aunt Esther like this?
Yeah, until they find some kind of cure for her.
I just came over here to ask you if you want me to cook dinner for you and your friends. But now, I wouldn't do nothing for you or any of your old sinful friends. Lamont, you always welcome to my house. But you, Fred Sanford, you old fish-eyed fool. Don't you ever set foot in my house again, huh, Glory? You old heathen.
That's in your cave, you old bat.
Mrs. Jefferson, I'm Florence Johnson, the agency secretary.
Oh, yes, come in. This is my husband.
How you do?
10 o'clock on the dot, Louise.
Oh, I believe in being prompt, Mr. Jefferson. I always say I ain't got no right to waste time when other people is paying for it.
I hear you. She's got the job.
Bye.
Martin, look, Cole's been gone for over an hour now, man. Pam, take your claw out of the glove, please, and turn on the radio. Just take it out and turn it on.
I got it, Pam. Stop starting with him. Does anybody know the quickest way there?
Yeah, on Pam's back. But we all can't fit, so, y'all can ride with me. Come on.
Come on now.
You know what? He gonna yell at me. My poor little couch. I know you haven't been dusted in years.
My poor little couch. I bet this is the first time you've been sat on by a buffalo.
Poor little walls. I feel so sorry for you to have to stay here and hear the language that comes out of this house.
Poor Wall, you ought to be glad you ain't got no eyes to see who's talking to you.
Why don't you move your smelly old feet so I can get the nap up on the rug?
Why don't you bend over so I can put my foot where to raise the nap on your head?
Why, you old bean-eating, beady-head, bell-hugging donkey.
It takes a jackass to know a donkey.
Why, you don't tell me.
I'm going to tell you anything.
Now, you ain't tell me nothing. I love you. Don't tell me.
I thought you two wasn't gonna talk to each other.
Well, son, I wasn't gonna say a word, but she came down here and tried to turn my sofa and wall against me.
Listen!
No, you listen. You see these two fists here? They stereo. And I'm gonna put them both in your ears.
I'm planning to run off to the Bahamas with all my money, Jim.
With all your money, man? Broke as you are, they not gonna run very far.
I wasn't even talking to you, Janet, jackass.
Martin Jefferson.
Yes, Martin.
Which one do you think is softer?
This one.
It may be soft, but at least it ain't hollow.
You have to excuse my maid. Every time she opens her mouth, her brain takes a coffee break.
Of course, you don't have that problem, because you ain't got no brain. What did you say needed dusting?
Never mind the dusting. We could use a couple of drinks. Scotch?
Fine.
That's very good, Mr. Jefferson. You keep changing your mind like that, and someday, maybe you'll end up with one that works.
And someday, maybe I'll end up with a maid that works.
I doubt it, because it ain't easy working in all this heat.
What heat?
All that hot air coming out your mouth.
Oh, wow, this is nice. Tommy come by bearing gifts. Cole come by bearing gifts. Yeah. Pam, you just a bear that came by, huh? Are you shedding? Is it hibernation time? What's going on?
Are you shrinking? Is it shorty time? I'm not scared.
Hey, girl, what's up?
Hey.
Uh-oh, what's the matter? Is Martin acting his shoe size again?
Pam, I don't know what it is. We are arguing over the smallest things.
You mean like his height?
Come on, Pam, I'm serious.
All right. Tommy wakes up. He needs to see some friendly faces. Okay? I said friendly faces. Okay? Not furry faces. Stay.
Look, no matter what shape Tommy is in, just don't react, okay?
Well, what if he looks really bad?
We've been looking at you all these years. It can't get no worse.
Okay, look, we'll just act like nothing happened.
It's Gina!
Yeah, and it's your boy Cole Brown. Remember me? What's up, Tommy?
Hey, Tommy. Pam's here. Hi, baby.
Pam, would you back up off him? Girl, your breath gonna put him in a coma.
Shut up!
And what the hell is Pam doing back there? What, are you giving her another flea bath?
Actually, I was lowering the sink so you can reach it.
I ain't even with you right now. Let me talk.
Woodrow and I are gonna have a baby. Well, somebody better call the zoo.
Would you stop?
Just leave him alone, because, honey, ain't nothing he can say or do to dampen my spirits. I am going to be a mother. Thanks. Watch it, sucker.
Hey, congratulations, Uncle Woody.
Thank you, Lamont.
Huh?
Now, this calls for a drink.
Congratulations, Aunt Esther.
Thank you, baby.
If she gonna have a baby, you better call for a veterinarian.
What's the matter with you, Pop? How can you be so cruel, Aunt Esther and Uncle Woody, on the happiest day of their life?
Because they're both too old and too ugly to have a baby.
Nothing about babies.
Who? Fred G. Sanford? The G stands for Goo Goo Gaga. And gynecologist.
Well, it just so happened, Mr. Fred G. Sanford, that we're not gonna have this baby the way you had Lamont.
You gonna have this baby on purpose?
Well, they call you Big Ears.
Yeah, well, he should have called me Bigfoot, because he's going to have a problem pulling my boot out of
him. Oh, please, he wouldn't waste his time fighting a little ant like you. He'd just spray you with Raid and call it a day.
You know what?
What's this, Gina?
Give me that. It's Martin's wedding ring.
Damn, I knew Martin was small, but where's the rest of him? Yo, Martin. Martin. You know what?
Thank you.
And, who are you playing, Pam? Romeo's horse?
I like to play Mike Tyson and knock your teeth out.
No, you might want to use your right claw.
Okay.
Pam, why do you gotta come over here and watch our TV all the time? Oh, my bad. You can't afford one, huh?
You are just so childish. Why don't you grow up? Oh, my bad. You can't.
You see, Gina, I would let you keep her, but your Pam got to stay off the couch.
Okay.
Come on, Florence, it's time to go.
All right.
Well, hurry up, woman.
You think I'm ready to travel?
Sure, your broom is in the closet. George!
Florence, you look very, colorful. Why, thank you, Jenny.
Yeah.
I say one thing. If she gets air sick in that dress, ain't nobody gonna notice it.
Make a recommendation to the court. I know we'll like him. I just hope he likes us.
I know he'll like you, Esther.
Why, thank you, Fred.
Children always love animals.
Fred Sanford, you are the lowest of the low, and the meanest of the mean, and the baddest of the bad.
And you are the ugliest of the ugly.
That did it. Get it, Woodrow.
Woodrow.
Bang, bang!
Baby. You sure you don't want to be in the play? It might be fun now.
No. Not me, Gina. That play too corny for me.
Gina, he can't be in it. I mean, this is Romeo and Juliet, not Pee-wee's Big Adventure.
Well, you can't be in it either, Pam.
Why?
Because we're not doing 101 Dalmatians.
To the man out of eye.
Not I. Aren't you gonna need a stool?
Yeah, I'm gonna use the same stool I use when I milk you, Elsie.
You think maybe she could hook you up with a facelift?
No, but she can lift that tartar off your teeth.
Marty, I told you about show.
I didn't know you needed our help. I thought Mighty Mouse had special powers.
Try to be a little nice to Aunt Esther. I mean, after all, she is Mom's sister, you know?
Oh, gang. Esther, on behalf of Elizabeth, please sit down and feel at home.
Thank you.
And Esther, on behalf of Elizabeth, would you care for something to eat?
Oh, I wouldn't mind a little snack.
Well, son, go in the kitchen and fix your Aunt Esther a fish head sandwich.
You can insult me all you want to now, Fred Sanford, because when I'm chosen Mrs. Watts' business wife, your insulting days are gonna be over.
I didn't know that you entered in that contest.
I didn't only enter into it, I'm gonna win it. Right, Woodrow?
Yeah, right.
Wrong. That's the first place you can enter that contest because you're not eligible. See, one of the things you have to be is a part of a certain race.
What race?
Human. Esther, do like I tell you. Forget about that. Bow out. Keep yourself from being embarrassed.
Why should I be embarrassed? I got everything it takes to win that contest. When I was born, my body was blessed by Mother Nature, honey.
And as you got older, it was cursed by Father Time.
Martin, Mr. Lopez turned off your heat because you didn't pay your rent.
All right, look, everybody stay calm. All right? Now, we're all men around here. There's only one woman up in here, and that's my baby.
You better be quiet, Frosty the Short Man.
You know what? It's a good thing Shorty didn't have too far to fall. He really could have gotten hurt.
Good thing it wasn't you, Pam. You know, when horses hurt a leg, they take them out in the pasture and let off a few rounds.
So bad.
Okay? Everybody's not like Tommy. I don't have a pit bull to protect me.
That's it.
Well, I'm gonna live. I knew it. This is all your fault, Pam. They don't want me having pets up in my place. Get the leash. You got the goat,
Martin.
What? Okay, look, I just got to make a few calls. Just stall them, okay? Stall the audience.
Wait, stall them how? I don't know, Tommy.
Go out there and do some magic. Pull Pam out the hat, all right? Bonnie and Cole will be here any minute. Y'all know what to do?
Yeah, baby. We break her down till she comes clean.
Okay, now, Gina.
Right.
You get the handcuffs we had the other night.
Okay,
get them. Pam?
Nasty.
If she come in here acting crazy, I want you to start barking. Okay? As loud as you can. Bark! Boom. This way the neighbors hear you, everybody comes running.
Why don't you try flapping your ears and flying after her?
Whatever.
about?
You just don't invite the hoochie that's on the invite.
Because I told him I had a better hoochie for him, you.
I ain't no hoo.
Ooh. See? Oh. You shouldn't get mad at me.
Oh.
Hey, oh. Hey. Pam, what's all the damn howling about? Ain't no full moon out, woman.
Stop it. Her tooth is still bothering her.
Oh, what? The tooth still bothering you? All right, well, cool. Look, let me put on CD, all right? Because they say, music calms the savage beast.
I will curse you out with a bad tooth. You know that, don't you?
Look, don't go on spoil your mouth like that. Don't even do that to yourself. If your tooth is rotten, you're going to spoil it.
That did it. Come on, Woodrow, let's go. Now, come on!
No, you run along, Esther. There's something I want to discuss with Lamont.
Well, I'll go and do some shopping.
Goodbye, dear.
Oh, you call me dear?
Why should I call you dear? You look like Bambi's father.
You old weasel-eyed heathen.
Let's just get out of here.
I can't believe y'all just gonna leave Martin like this. Martin's always been there for you.
Well, I'm sorry, Gina, okay? I didn't know you needed our help. I thought Mighty Mouse had special powers.
Sit down! Damn it, I said sit down.
Don't touch me. Don't touch me.
Sit down. Ain't nobody going nowhere. Get the stand.
That's right, y'all got the stand.
Oh, you're gonna tell us to be at the stand. Get out of here. Get out of here. Get out of here. In my mind?
Maybe it could be Mad Dog.
Could be.
Well, get the phone, man.
What are you, scared?
I'm not scared. Back up off me and stop breathing right here. Okay, we gotta be smart about this, because we're gonna be here a minute. Okay, now, we got one bottle of water.
Got it.
Okay, one can of cream corn.
Cream.
We got a half a tube of toothpaste. Tommy, what you got, bro? What you got?
I found a peanut in the coat.
All right. Okay, because we're gonna need that peanut. Bring the peanut right here.
Right.
Now we're getting somewhere.
There. Right.
Okay. Pam, how much food you got stored up in your cheese? I know she got food because she's swollen right now.
Very funny, Martin. I'm sure you have some lucky charms somewhere hidden on you, little leprechaun.
What?
Yeah. Come back to clean delicious.
Wanna cut the cheddar and get the stink off me?
Okay, what can I do to help?
Okay, I'll tell you what you can do to help. To help her get out of that, you can tell us how you sneak out of your cage every night at the kennel. I mean, how do you just get out?
Only if you can tell me how you could walk under a door with it being closed inch high.
Look, just make yourself useful and start chewing through the bars, all right? You 90s women have just gotten a little lazy.
Brother,
yeah.
Please, women work just as hard as the men.
Who told you that? Who told you that?
You should try cooking dinner for yourself. Oh, no, that's if you can reach the stove. Short boy, R.D.
Short boy, R.D.
Like I said it.
Okay, Tommy, you better check your pet, all right? If I go to the taser on a fat bam right on.
But you know what? Son of a gun. Esther, how you feel?
I feel fine, Fred. And I ain't got no money to loan you. If that's why you asked me over here, I might as well go.
No, wait a minute. I ain't asked you over here to borrow no money. If I wanted some money, I'd ask you over the phone.
Hello there, Esther.
Hello, Lamont.
Hey, Pop, I gotta make a few pickups on the truck. I'll be right back.
Okay, son. Take it easy, son. And be careful, son. Bye, son.
Now, what you call me over here for, friend?
Sit down, Esther. Take the load off.
Let's get it over with, Fred. I don't like being alone in the house with an unmarried man.
Listen, Esther. If we were alone on a raft in the middle of the ocean, I'd rather kiss an octopus in the mouth.
Hey,
And y'all know I'm a brother with good ideas.
That's right.
Okay? I got a dollar and a dream to make myself some cream. Okay? Are you down or what? Are you down?
I'll be down. Yeah. I'm gonna be right there when you fall flat on your face. Luckily for you, that's not too far to fall.
You just make sure that you tell Dino and your crew don't be eating up all the meat. You hear me?
Your boy, you got to get that brother a job, Martin.
Something simple. Somewhere he won't be tearing up stuff.
Plus, Martin, didn't you say you needed somebody to help you out down at the station?
I said, help me out, Gina, not put me out of business, baby.
Look, Martin, it doesn't take a genius to work in TV. Now, be for real. I mean, look at you.
And it doesn't take a genius to catch a frisbee in your mouth. Now, does it, Queenie? Huh?
Now, I didn't come here for no fight. I just came for a little donation for the church. But it looks like I'm too late.
That's not true, Esther. Put me down for five.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Fred Sanford, $5.
Not $5, five knuckles.
Okay, old sinner. But just remember tonight, when you look around his empty house, just remember that the Lord giveth and the Lord taketh away. High glory!
And you remember when you look in the mirror tonight, the Lord gave you that face and you stuck with it.
Hey, so what? When we go back home, we don't even want to see y'all. Y'all, we need our space.
We don't want to see y'all. We need our space. Hey! There's a puppy behind you, man.
That ain't no damn
No matter how much we fight, hey, we got each other's back. That's what's important.
Man, please. I had to. That little thing outweighed your little ass.
Thank you anyway. I know it must be difficult for you fighting a family member.
See how